A very good afternoon to all the dignitaries on and off the dais. At the outset, I would like to thank AIOS ARC for giving me the opportunity to speak on this platform. The topic that I have today is training in wet laboratory is required before surgery on actual patients or not. And I am speaking for the view. By failing to prepare, you are preparing to fail. This old adage by Benjamin Franklin cannot be more relevant as far as surgical training in ophthalmology is concerned. As we all know that ophthalmology sets itself apart from other surgical specialties in that it requires additional skills of hand-eye coordination. It requires microsurgical skills, that is working under the microscope, and you have to handle delicate tissues in a confined space. It becomes a multitasking of sorts when a resident is performing phacoemulsification. So all this becomes highly stressful and intimidating for a resident or a novice surgeon. And when the outcomes are suboptimal, the confidence of the surgeon nosedives. Also, there's a growing concern these days for ethical issues. Just because a certain patient is less demanding, less resourceful, does not mean that the patient deserves excellent outcomes any less. And we should not forget that we are dealing with human eyes, and we cannot afford to make too many mistakes. And if mistakes do happen, we cannot leave them unaddressed. So there's a growing emphasis on revamping the surgical training in India and worldwide. It has been told and suggested that there should be a comprehensive, structured, supervised curriculum for surgical training involving wet laboratory and the use of surgical simulators. Various studies have also proved that wet laboratory training helps the residents to get familiar with machine settings. It helps them to get familiar with ophthalmic microsurgical instruments. It helps them to get the optimal use of the operating microscope. And we all know that wet laboratory still remains the gold standard as far as learning proper wound construction is concerned and learning corneoscleral suturing techniques is concerned. And all this the new surgeon can do in a non-stressful, risk-free environment. So there's a definite reduced learning curve. There is increased level of confidence, and there's a reduced number of complications and better outcomes when operating on live human eyes. Besides, the Accreditation Council for Graduate Medical Education has recognized the importance of wet laboratory training in ophthalmology, and it has mandated the wet laboratory or simulation training in USA for ophthalmology residency programs. Now, I would like to say a few words about ICO Oscar, which is this International Council of Ophthalmology designed this ophthalmology surgical tool to facilitate assessment and teaching of surgical skills. Here, the surgical procedures are broken down to individual steps, and each step is graded on a scale of novice, beginner, advanced beginner, and competent. A description of the performance is necessary to achieve each grade in each step is given. The assessor simply circles the observed performance and at each step of the procedure. The ICO Oscar should be completed at the end of the case and immediately discussed with the student to provide timely, structured, specific feedback. So to summarize, I would like to say that modern ophthalmology has become a surgical specialty which involves state-of-the-art surgical procedures with excellent visual outcomes. Hence, students should be educated with specific and dedicated teaching programs involving wet laboratory experience and use of standardized assessment tools to ensure surgical competency and maximum safety. Thank you.